Good morning, children. In the previous video, I gave you an idea about the physiological process. Okay, all the systems, just in short, I just gave you an idea. I introduced the topic to you. Now we take up one-one systems in detail, each system in detail. The first system which we are supposed to take up is nutrition, of course. Pet puja pehle, am I right? Okay, so what do you understand by nutrition? It is a physiological process by which you supply nutrients, various nutrients to your body. Okay, so for that, the nutrition can be broadly classified into whether the animal or the living organism is able to make it on its own or it is dependent. So you have the autotrophic mode of nutrition and the heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Okay, so normally the organisms, they use food material which are obtained from inorganic sources, either in the form of carbon dioxide and water. We are also making use of it, but we are indirectly making use of carbon dioxide and water. Okay, because we depend on plant, and plant uses these two inorganic material. So therefore, you and me are also indirectly making use of carbon dioxide and water, because that forms a carbohydrate, which is the source for our survival. Now, in case of living organisms, for all the various processes which are taking place, there is a very important word which comes up every now and then. It's called the enzymes. They are called the biocatalyst. What is catalyst? Any substance which increases the speed of the reaction is called a catalyst. It doesn't take part in the reaction, but it speeds the reaction. So in the living system, such catalysts are called biocatalysts, which are generally called enzymes. Clear? So now, all the organisms which can make their food on their own, that is mainly the green chlorophyll bearing plants and certain bacteria, they are called autotrophs. Remaining are all the other organisms, living organisms, except the green plants and the bacteria. They are except them, all the remaining are heterotrophic organism. Okay, heterotrophs means dependent on the autotrophs. So what are autotrophic nutrition? What is autotrophic nutrition? For autotrophic nutrition, a simple point to be kept in mind is here. Autotroph means plants making their own food. So the basic raw material which is required is carbon dioxide. Second, water. Third, chlorophyll. Fourth, sunlight. These four parameters are a must for photosynthetic reaction to take place. Any one of this, if it is removed, then the process will stop. So photosynthetic equation is given like this. In this photosynthetic equation, carbon dioxide comes from the soil, comes from the environment in gaseous form, that is absorbed through the stomata, an opening in the leaf. Water is absorbed by the root system from the soil. Chlorophyll is already present as a pigment in the green plant, in the chloroplast. 9th standard, you come across what a chloroplast is. So in the chloroplast, there is a pigment called the chlorophyll that is present in the green chlorophyll bearing plant. So if this green chlorophyll is not there, no photosynthesis. Clear or not? Okay. Sunlight, another important factor, because sunlight or the solar energy is trapped and it is incorporated. It is helping these two things to be converted into finally the food. This is the food with on which you and me are surviving. Glucose, or it is also called the carbohydrate in general. So carbon dioxide and water in presence of sunlight with the help of chlorophyll converted into carbohydrate by liberating, by giving out oxygen and water. This is photosynthetic equation. So if you actually see, I told you, know that all these four are very, very important for the reaction, photosynthetic reactions to take place. So photosynthetic reaction, if you try to sum up, will have three main steps. These are the three main steps, which is very, very important. Very important question. Which events are formed during the autotrophic reaction or the photosynthetic reaction? This alone can be asked for a 2 marker. Give the equation for photosynthesis. So this is the equation for photosynthesis. Okay. If they ask you to define photosynthesis, then you will say that carbon dioxide, when it reacts with water in presence of chlorophyll and sunlight, it will form glucose by liberating oxygen and water. That is a photosynthesis definition. Now the events which are involved in photosynthesis is three important events: absorption of light, conversion of light, and reduction of carbon dioxide. Clear? Light is absorbed by the chlorophyll. So I told you, chlorophyll is very, very important. If chlorophyll is not there, absorption of light will not take place. Clear? So absorption of light takes place in the chlorophyll of the leaf. So leaf is called the kitchen of the plant. After the light is absorbed, that light energy is splitting the water molecule into hydrogen and oxygen. So again, a very important objective which is asked: the oxygen which is liberated, from where does it come? It comes from the water molecule. Yes. So oxygen is given out from the water molecule. Splitting water gives out oxygen gas. So conversion of light energy takes place, and the light energy is used to split water into hydrogen and oxygen. At the same time, the carbon dioxide gets converted into carbohydrate. It is reduced to carbohydrate. Clear? So these three processes together helps in converting the carbon dioxide and water into finally glucose. Clear? Okay. Now, to understand, I told you that it's very important these ingredients, that is carbon dioxide, water, sunlight, chlorophyll, all these are very important for photosynthesis. Now, in your book, there are many activities which are shown. The very first activity is giving you the emphasis that chlorophyll is very necessary for photosynthesis. Before we move into the activity part of it, let me give you an idea that in all the three activities, one thing is very common. And what is a common thing? You come across the word destarch. Destarch stands for removing starch. For removing starch, what should you do? The plant, the potted plant, usually we take the potted plant. You don't take the rooted plant. Yani zameen pe lage hue paude nahi select karte usually. It is a potted plant so that you can move in and out of the room. So a potted plant which you are selecting, that has to be kept in the dark for 3 to 4 days. When you keep a plant away from the sunlight for 3 to 4 days, it will utilize the complete starch which has been prepared till then for its own physiology. It will not die for 3 to 4 days if it is kept away from sunlight. It's not going to die because the starch which has been stored till then, prepared till then, is utilized for its living. So by the time the starch gets used up, you say that the starch is removed. That is called destarch. So it is kept away in the dark for destarch. Now, then keep this potted plant in the sunlight. So after keeping it for 3 to 4 days in the dark, it is then kept in the sunlight for 6 hours. That means new photosynthetic reaction, that means new starch will be formed. The previous formed starch has been already utilized. So now the new formation of starch starts, new photosynthetic reaction starts over there for the 6 hours which it has been kept. Now after 6 hours, then again what will you do? You will select any leaf, whichever leaf you have to perform the experiment, that leaf is selected. And then you dip it in boiling water. When you dip it in boiling water, what will happen? It's a cell membrane. Its cell wall becomes broken, denatured, isn't it? And then the leaf is dipped in alcohol. But the alcohol is kept in a water bath. What do you mention by water bath? Alcohol cannot be directly kept on heat because alcohol is vaporizing. It will catch fire. Very dangerous. So therefore, alcohol is taken in a small beaker. And that beaker containing alcohol is kept in another beaker which is having water. So if I diagrammatically try to show you, this will be the beaker containing water and this will be the beaker containing alcohol. Here it is alcohol and here it is water. And this is water part is heated with the help of the Bunsen burner. Am I clear? This is kept on a stand, of course. So the beaker with water, in that you keep a small container with alcohol. So that alcohol is not directly come in contact with the flame, but it's the water which gets heated and then the alcohol becomes warm. So into that warm alcohol, you are dipping the leaf which has initially been dipped in the boiling water. By doing so, what happens is the starch portion, the chlorophyll gets removed and then you can test for the starch. These are the steps for starch testing and this too is for destarching. So this will be the common step which you will come across in any activity of essential things required for photosynthesis. So now let us move into the activity part of it. Activity number one which is given over here is chlorophyll is essential for photosynthesis. This is to prove that. What they have said is you take a potted plant with variegated leaf. Variegated leaf means what? A leaf which is having like this, multi sections, means green patches. It's not completely green, but green patches are there. That is called a variegated leaf. Now, you keep it in the dark for few days. So what do? You destarch it. Now you keep it in the 6 hours for sunlight. Now, any one leaf which you are going to test, that leaf is to be taken up and you mark the green areas in it. Means you take the leaf and then you mark wherever the green patches are there that you keep in mind. Now you dip that leaf in the boiling water and then you immerse it in beaker containing alcohol. Alcohol beaker, I told you, should be kept in water bath. I explained it all just now. Now what will you find is when you dip in the alcohol, the color fades. Okay, and now you add a few drop of iodine on the leaf. When you add iodine on the leaf, all those patches which were green earlier and has become lighter, decolorized, will turn to bluish black in color. All the patches which were green earlier will become bluish black in color, indicating presence of starch. Did you understand that? So this shows that earlier, though the leaf was completely destarched, means there was no previous starch present in the leaf, then you kept it for 6 hours in the sunlight, so the process of photosynthesis starts, and that photosynthesis is utilizing the chlorophyll which is present in these green colored parts, and then it is preparing food, that is starch is prepared over there. How will you test the reaction for starch? Yes, you take the leaf, boiling water you immerse, then you immerse it into alcohol, and then you add iodine solution on it. So if the starch is being formed, then it will turn to bluish color, indicating the presence of starch. Clear? The second activity which is given over here is carbon dioxide is important. How will you know that carbon dioxide is important? For that, see, there are two plants which are taken. Both the plants should be of the same variety, same type, same pattern, same healthy growth. Now, what I am supposed to do is, again, the first step to be done is you destarch it. I told you, you always keep it in the dark for destarching, because otherwise the previous starch which is there, that will give you a wrong result. So both the potted plants, if you keep it in the dark for few days, the complete starch which was formed till then will be utilized for its physiology. Now, after 2 to 3 days of keeping in dark, now you keep the potted plants in the sunlight for just 4 to 5 hours. 4 to 5 hours means little amount of photosynthetic activity will take place. So little amount of starch will be formed in the leaf. Clear? But before you place it into the sunlight, before you place it for 6 hours in the sunlight, there is a slight change in the arrangement. What is the arrangement which you have to change? One of the plant, you simply cover it with a glass. Okay, this is a glass jar by which you have covered the potted plant. The second potted plant, before you cover it, you place a dish in which there is potassium hydroxide. You know what does potassium hydroxide do? It will absorb the carbon dioxide which has been trapped in this region. So this particular air inside the jar will be without carbon dioxide. Whereas here, such a material is not kept. Potassium hydroxide is not kept. So here carbon dioxide will be available. So, as I told you, after destarching, before you place the potted plant in sunlight, you have to cover them with the bell jar. Before you cover it, in one of the case, you place potassium hydroxide, in the other one, you don't place it. Now, let this arrangement be there for 4 to 5 hours or 6 hours. After that, remove one leaf each from both the plants. You should label it properly, huh? Suppose isko A kaha, isko B kaha, so you should know which plant is the one where potassium hydroxide is kept. The leaf of that plant should be marked separately. So you take a leaf from both the plants and then again perform the same step which I told you earlier. What are the steps? Dip it in boiling water, then alcohol, and then you add a drop of iodine on the leaf. You will find that the leaf which you have taken up from the pot, which was kept along with potassium hydroxide, in that leaf there won't be any color change. Whereas the other leaf which has been taken from the potted plant, which did not contain KOH, that is potassium hydroxide, in that case the leaf turns bluish color, indicating presence of starch. So here carbon dioxide was there, so starch photosynthesis could take place and therefore starch was formed. But here no carbon dioxide, because carbon dioxide is absorbed by potassium hydroxide. So no carbon dioxide and no photosynthesis, and hence the leaf doesn't show the presence of starch. This indicates carbon dioxide is necessary for photosynthetic reaction. Clear? So these are the two activities. I'll try to search one more activity regarding the role of sunlight. And then all these three activity videos, if I get, I'll put it in the WhatsApp group. Okay, so that you will understand it better. Clear about it? Okay. Now, we said that carbon dioxide is necessary. But how does carbon dioxide enter the plant? Well, carbon dioxide enters the plant through the space which is called the stomata. Okay, openings. So, for that, there is a picture given in your book. This is the picture. This is how the leaf is. This is the portion of the leaf which has been magnified. Ye wala part is magnified over here. So, this upper line will be the upper epidermis. Lower line will be the lower epidermis. Clear? So, here is the upper epidermis. These are the upper epidermis layer on which there is a thin layer of line which is showing the waxy. Wax deposition. Cuticle kaha jata hai. So, upper line, this upper line over here is the upper epidermis. Lower line is the lower epidermis. On the lower epidermis, you will find that it is not intact. See, here it is continuous, but here it's not continuous. There is space. Clear? This opening is called the stomata, which is having cells guarding it, protecting it. They are called the guard cells. Okay? So, guard cells have an opening in center called the stomata. This arrangement you generally find at the lower side, not on the upper side. Even if it is there in the upper side, the number will be lesser but more on the lower side. Why? Because the upper region is directly in contact with the sunlight. So, to prevent the loss of water, generally the stomata is provided in the lower region. Further, a better picture of stomata is given on the next page. Here you have it. This is how it looks like. This is the stomatal opening. This is the guard cell. The guard cell are also having chlorophyll. This green colored dots are the chlorophyll in the guard cells. Chloroplast having chlorophyll. This is open condition and this is closed condition. Means the opening is opened as well as closed by the movement of guard cells. How does it move and does the work? Here it is explained over here. So what are stomata? They are tiny pores present on the surface of the leaves. Okay. Now, when large amount of water is lost from the stomata, the plant closes these pores and hence carbon dioxide cannot enter. When is large amount of water lost? When this particular cell is turgid. Turgid means swollen up. The guard cells become turgid. At that time it becomes swollen up. At that time more water will be present inside. You say turgid kaha jata, phula hua condition. So more water in the guard cells, so water will be lost. Water will come out and through this opening it will be evaporated into the environment. So the cells will become more, it will shrink down. The guard cells, when they shrink down, what will happen? The opening will close. So the carbon dioxide cannot be absorbed. Generally during night time, this situation takes place. During night time, the guard cells are, the guard cells shrink, due to which the opening closes. Why does guard cells shrink in size? Because the water is already lost and the starch which was formed in the guard cells has slowly moved into the neighboring cells. Due to this mechanism, the guard cells remain, the guard cells closes the opening. So at night there is no photosynthetic reaction, but during daytime what happens? Again the chloroplasts in the guard cells start photosynthetic activity, due to which there will be starch present inside and hence water will move into this and water can be taken out. This mechanism of opening and closing of the guard cells helps in the moving, the taking in of carbon dioxide and removing oxygen from the plant. Clear? So, I'll also try to support with a video about the opening and closing mechanism of the stomata. Clear about it? Okay. Next is about the water. The water used in photosynthesis. Water is also very important, I told you, no? Fourth element. One is carbon dioxide, chlorophyll, sunlight, and a fourth material which is required is water. So water is used in photosynthesis, is taken up by from the soil by the root system. The roots absorb the water and then supplies the water to the upper parts of the plant. Along with water, the nutrients which are required for the biological functioning of the plant is taken up. That means the nutrients which are dissolved in the water is taken up from the soil, out of which nitrogen becomes a very, very important element because that is required for the synthesis of protein. Clear? So this is what you have all in the autotrophic type of nutrition. Clear, Tilia? There is a bacteria which you have already come across in 9th standard. This particular bacteria I've already mapped, rhizobium bacteria. Do you remember? It helps in trapping the atmospheric nitrogen and fixes it for the plants, legumes. It helps in fixing the nitrogen for the leguminous plants. Clear? But otherwise, the nitrogen are absorbed from the soil with the help of the root system. Not only nitrogen, all the nutrients, mineral elements are absorbed by the water, which is by absorption with the help of the water. So the next video we'll take up about the heterotrophic nutrition. Thank you.